So here we are, born to beat up bad guys in the mean streets. At least that's the premise. Welcome to a new version of the Fame Beat 'em Up from the 80s. Double Dragon Gaiden, Rise of the Dragons, was released not too long ago on the Nintendo Switch, PlayStation systems, Xbox systems, and PC via Steam. And here is your beastly review. Let's get into it. Straightforward, and yes, I am a gamer that enjoys a story. I am just now finding out there are some people that don't like a story. Weird, but I digress. Double Dragon Gaiden takes place in the year 19XX, which means we are in the future surpassing Double Dragon. This time around, the mayor is asking for our help to fix what is going on with the four gangs of the city. We have the Killers, the Royals, the Triangle, and Okada. Each themed gang has their own leader that will try to be a real problem. But fear not, warrior! Because you are not fighting alone. Listen, I'm not kidding. Double Dragon Gaiden. There is a new style of two-player combat where a single player will swap between characters during combat. It is an interesting twist to this style, but I can only assume it is hard for most to get that co-op going online at times. However, it is like a second chance, honestly, if one goes down or if their health is too low, you can swap out. Kind of gives you that Marvel vs. Capcom fighting game feeling. At first, you start off with four characters. The famous Lee brothers, Billy and Jimmy, who are more versatile in combat. Then there's Uncle Matten and Marion, who, as most of you do know, is not new as a playable character. She did play as a playable character in River City Girls 2, but this will be her first time being a playable character in Double Dragon. She was a villain in Double Dragon Neon, which is quite interesting. I am going to do an abridged version as I did my full write-up, which you can check out on my Patreon page. So before you begin, you can set the settings for your run to make it easier or harder. This will determine the funds you receive or earn during your progression. The harder you set the difficulty, the less things you will cost. There is even a permadeath option for those that are bold, you know who you are. Want to be the tryhards, but it's okay, I respect that. Once you have your settings and chosen your characters, it's time to kick some honey buns! Each character works differently with their abilities, where Billy and Jimmy are your all-arounders, able to pick up weapons, off the floor, and dodge roll, while Matten is more of your brute, with a riot shield, and he can pick up characters to perform an AoE damage. AoE, for kids that don't know, is area of effect. He'll just damage the whole area. If there's a whole group around you, he just slams the character right on the ground. It's pretty sweet. Marion, on the other hand, brings out the Glock and regulates some fools. Yeah, that's right, she is on her Second Amendment rights. I tell you this right now. As you progress, you can choose which missions to start off with first, and depending on who will be your first, it will be easy. Now, as you progress, each boss gets tougher, as the mission 4 boss will be fully realized with ultimate power. So that's right, this is how I got the trophies for the different boss endings. You will have to defeat each boss differently on mission 4, and they will be tough. You will have your basic attacks and special abilities that come in SP1, SP2, and SP3. There's a special meter gauge to refill easily. Once you beat up people, it refills pretty quickly. At this point, a spoiler warning is in effect. I will give you some time. Skip ahead on the marker after the spoiler, you know, just go get some lunch, make yourself some snack. Okay, I'll wait. So after you defeat the gangs, the mayor gives you a choice to join him to be peace enforcers, and I use that quotation marks, which you will get a nice $10,000 bonus, or refuse, and he becomes a real SOB uber boss fight. This boy rips off his clothes and becomes like Fist of the North Star. It's crazy. But you will infiltrate City Hall, take on many special forces, minions, and refight all four gang members until you finally face off with the mayor. He was a real piece of work, but defeatable after a few tries. Then after this, you will get a nice hefty sum of $20,000. That is two times of what you was going to get. This was neat as you have an option of two different endings. It's pretty cool. All right, that's the end of the spoiler. Okay, everybody good? Everybody cool? Cool. All right. After each mission, you can upgrade your fighters with in-game currency. You can see what works best for you, or you can bypass it all entirely and just pocket the money. Doing crowd control moves will grant you health items, meaning if you defeat enemies in groups of 3, 4, and 5, will determine the health amount you will get. Hot dogs give you 25% back, burgers give you 50%, and the whole turkey dinner gives you 100% back health. Using your specials or weapons will give you the crowd control finishers. Use it wisely and at the right time. Visually, it all looks good and pixelated as a bit of both modern and old school flair, thanks to both Modus games and Arc System Works. Music is pretty good as well as the sound design around the combat. Then you have collectibles to obtain with tokens you get after you cash out. This is an incentive for the replay value that even though the tips and musics are, you know, 1 coin each, the other unlockable players go from 10 to 25 coins. So get there and make bank as you beat up enemies and objects in the area to grab currency. That's right, the real strategy to this is when you reach a boss fight, let the enemies flow in because the more you beat up, the more money you earn. That's just a quick tip. Real talk, playing felt a bit stiff. Not all the characters work as well as you would think at first. Using anyone outside of Billy and Jimmy comes with a challenge as they don't pick up items or have a dodge animation much. The walking around kind of feels a bit stiff, not as loose as other beat 'em ups that I played. However, with the upgrades, it can make things work better. Not that bad, but could use some improvement. All in all, Double Dragon Gaiden was worth the money. It was $24, I want to say, but I had a discount and got it for $14. Great replay value, a lot of characters to utilize with. I would say find the best combinations that work best for you. And if you got a buddy, you can go in co-op and really take on the challenges. The achievements are pretty easy to get. I'm almost about to platinum it, so it's not that bad. I would say 25 to 30 hours completion time would take, depending on how much you want to do and what kind of scale you want to get through. But in all, to do one run through of this is like 2+ hours. It's not that bad, but it's a beat 'em up. So like I said, the replay value is all in the replaying and unlocking all the stuff. But at the end of the day, it was a nice return to Double Dragon. I'm not disappointed. And I will have to give it 4 out of 5 beastly paws. Alright gamers, this is your boy Beast Game Akuma. Thank you again for checking out this review. Please hit that like and subscribe button. We are over 1,351 subscribers. I'm just trying to get the watch hours up. So please, check out my videos. Leave comments. Hit that like or dislike, don't matter. I just like all the feedback. I want to discuss it with you. If you are playing Double Dragon Gaiden, let me know what your thoughts are. And I'll see y'all in the next video. Beast out.